your money. Now, today's housing market is sizzling, and if you're a buyer, it can be difficult to find a home, even tougher to be the winning bidder. CBS4's financial expert Andy Manley joins us now to talk about the options to consider putting into your offer and the actions that you could take to put you into a new home. Andy, a pleasure to have you here. As always, we'll get right to it here. What are the steps that can make your offer stand out from others?
Well, the first is to put in a cash offer, but since most people can't do that, the next best thing is to make sure you have a pre-approval, not a pre-qualification, from a reputable lender, because that signals to the buyer that you're really able to close the loan, and that's the most important thing. And maybe you even want to put down a larger earnest money deposit, because once again, you want to be able to show them you can get through any closing issues.
So what's a typical issue in today's market that can derail a closing?
One of the biggest right now is that the appraisal comes in less than the purchase price on the house. So if you put in an appraisal gap guarantee is what it's called, saying, hey, if the appraisal doesn't come in high enough, I've got more money to put down and we'll get this loan closed.
Gotcha. You always want to put your best foot forward there, we know. So are there any red flags to avoid when putting your offer in?
Yeah, one is having a lot of contingencies. It used to be you could say, oh, I need to sell my home and I don't want to close until this time frame and all of those things. Now you need to be flexible and really meet the seller's timeline and not have any of those types of contingencies. And you also have to kind of think about how you want to handle inspections as well.
All right, this is something I've been hearing a lot of people doing, and it kind of makes me cringe a little bit. Is it a good idea to waive all inspections to make your offer better?
I really don't think that's the way you want to go. I think what you can do is maybe do what's called a pass-fail inspection, saying that you're not going to make the seller fix anything that comes up in the inspection, but if there's a major structural issue, that you're going to walk away. Now, you're probably going to lose some of your earnest money, but it's better to do that than to have a major problem with the house. So I would feel more comfortable in that situation from an inspection standpoint.
What about the so-called escalation clauses? Can those help as well?
Yeah, that's a really important thing to do. But it starts with you have to have a really good offer. And so if you make your best offer, but you just want to make sure someone doesn't beat you by a little bit, work with your realtor to have a kind of an automatic escalation clause that you can put in. Just make sure that you don't get so caught up in winning the house that it becomes that you spent too much on the house or causes other problems. So you can't really win at all costs.
Gotcha. All right. Good advice there, Andy. I know a lot of people struggling with home buying in these past couple months. Good advice there. Thank you. We'll see you next week, buddy.